Which guest? The Secretary of State of the United States, accompanied by the Prime Minister of Sweden and the Minister of Foreign Affairs of Sweden.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for being here today. Prime Minister Kristersson, accompanied by Foreign Minister Billström, will now deposit Sweden's instrument of accession to the North Atlantic Treaty, with Secretary of State Blinken representing the United States of America as the depositary of the treaty.
Welcome. Well, good things come to those who wait. No better example. But with receipt of this instrument of accession, let me be the very first to welcome Sweden as a party to the Washington Treaty and the 32nd member of the North Atlantic Treaty Organization. Prime Minister, to you, to my friend the Foreign Minister, a personal note of thanks for your extraordinary leadership, your extraordinary vision, and your resilience. This has been a little bit of a road, but I think we've known from day one that we would be here today, and now we are. This is a historic moment for Sweden. It's historic for our alliance. It's historic for the transatlantic relationship. Our NATO alliance, our defensive alliance, is now stronger and larger than it's ever been. But I think if you step back and think of where we were 3 years ago, none of this was foreordained, and in fact, none of this was foreseeable. Sweden had a 200-year-old policy of non-alignment. And before Putin's re-invasion of Ukraine in February of 2022, if you looked at the polling, less than one-third of Swedes supported joining NATO. This was part and parcel of Sweden's history. And then everything changed. After the invasion, three-quarters of the Swedish people made clear their desire to join. Swedes realized something very profound, that if Putin was willing to try to erase one neighbor from the map, then he might well not stop there. And if he was allowed to proceed with impunity, not only would his aggression potentially continue, but would-be aggressors everywhere would get the message that it was open season. And so the Swedish people stood up not only for their own country, but stood up to the common responsibility that we share to try to make sure that the very foundations of the international system that we all rely on to have peace, to have security, to have opportunity, when they were challenged, we were there to defend them. Sweden was there to defend them. And I think what this tells us even more profoundly is the reaffirmation of Sweden's democratic character. Change driven by its people, by its citizens. There's also no clearer example than today of the strategic debacle that Putin's invasion of Ukraine has become for Russia. We see a Russia that is now weaker militarily, economically, diplomatically. It's standing in Ukraine, has changed dramatically. Whereas before 2014, the first invasion, people were open to positive relations with Russia. Now virtually the entire society, and not just today, probably for generations, is turned against Russia because of its aggression. And fundamentally, our alliance is now, as I said, both larger and stronger than it's ever been. And we see again and again and again that everything Putin sought to prevent, he's actually precipitated by his actions, by his aggression. And there's no clearer example of that than Sweden becoming a member of this alliance. But even once that decision was made, none of this was easy, none of this was obvious. It's taken 2 years, nearly 2 years, of tireless diplomacy, together with the extraordinary Secretary General of NATO, Jens Stoltenberg, to achieve ratification by every NATO member. And again, the determination of Sweden's leadership, the extraordinary diplomacy that it's exerted, making sure that every question was answered, every challenge was met, every obstacle was overcome, that's what brought us to today. Now, some doubted that we'd get here. We never did, and we are here. This, of course, is also built on an extraordinary foundation of partnership between Sweden and NATO that goes back many, many years. Sweden's long been an active partner with NATO allies, training together, exercising together, working together. And fundamentally, the reason this is such a strong, powerful fit is because Sweden embodies and promotes the core values that are at the heart of NATO: democracy, liberty, the rule of law. And it also brings some unique capabilities to this enterprise, unique capabilities in the Arctic, the Baltic Seas. And this year, of course, Sweden will contribute more than 2% of its GDP to defense and continue to show the way for all NATO members. If you go back to 1949, at the signing of the NATO Treaty, President Truman said this, and I quote, "In taking steps to prevent aggression against our own peoples, we have no purpose of aggression against other peoples. We hope to create a shield against aggression and the fear of aggression, a bulwark which will permit us to get on with the real business of government society, the business of achieving a fuller and happier life for all of our citizens." That is fundamentally what this enterprise is all about, what NATO is all about. It's making sure that together we are creating an environment in which our people are safe, secure, and can meet their full potential. Today, we have fortified this shield against aggression. We brought more people under its protection so that together we can focus on the real work of delivering for our people. With that, Mr. Prime Minister, the floor is yours.
Thank you so much, Mr. Secretary. Antony, thank you so much. Today is a truly historic day. Sweden is now a member of NATO. We are deeply grateful for the overwhelming bipartisan congressional support for Sweden's accession and for the strong leadership from the U.S. administration leading the way on ratification and security assurances. I would personally like to thank both President Biden and you, Secretary Blinken, for your invaluable efforts and personal commitments during the accession process. I would also like to thank all NATO allies who have supported our accession and welcoming Sweden as a 32nd member of the alliance. We are humble, but we are also proud. We will live up to high expectations from all NATO allies. United we stand. Unity and solidarity will be Sweden's guiding light as a NATO member. We will share burdens, responsibilities, and risks with other allies. Today is, as Secretary Blinken said, it's a victory for freedom today. Sweden has made a free, democratic, sovereign, and united choice to join NATO. There is an overwhelming support in our parliament and among our people. That is a strength, both for Sweden and for the alliance. And as a strong democracy, Sweden will stand for the values in the Washington Treaty, signed just a few blocks from here, 75 years ago. Freedom, democracy, individual liberty, and the rule of law. Sweden is, as was mentioned, now leaving 200 years of neutrality and military non-alignment behind. It is a major step, but at the same time, a very natural step. Membership means that we are coming home to the Alliance for Peace and coming home to the Alliance for Freedom, to which many democracies already belong. Also home to our neighbors' security cooperation, home to the circle of countries where we, for generations, have belonged. We will defend freedom together with the countries closest to us, both in terms of geography, culture, and values. The security situation in our region has not been this serious since the Second World War. Russia will stay a serious threat to the Euro-Atlantic security for the foreseeable future. It was in this light that Sweden applied to join the NATO Defense Alliance, to gain security, but also to provide security. We have unique capabilities to contribute on land, in the air, at sea. Our support to Ukraine is a fundamental part of that. Ukraine is fighting bravely for its freedom, but they are also defending European freedom. At the same time, we are strengthening our defense and doubling the defense budget right now. From this year onwards, Sweden meets the NATO standard of 2% of GDP to defense spending. This is important for NATO security, obviously, and to burden sharing. We are increasing the numbers of conscripts, strengthening civil defense, and reintroducing civilian service in Sweden. We have been prepared for this task for quite a while, and I'm very pleased to take this very final step. Sweden is joining NATO. It's not the end of something. It's a beginning of something new. I look forward to making the world safer and freer together with the United States and all other NATO allies. And allow me, finally, a very short summary in Swedish. En väldigt kort sammanfattning på svenska. Det är en i sanning historisk dag idag. Sverige är från och med nu medlem i NATO. Jag vill personligen tacka både president Joe Biden och utrikesminister Blinken för ovärderliga insatser och deras personliga engagemang under hela den här anslutningsprocessen. Sverige lämnar nu 200 år av neutralitet och militär alliansfrihet. Det är ett stort steg, men också ett väldigt naturligt steg. Det här är en gemensam framgång för Sverige. Det är en historiskt kort process som tidvis ändå har känts lång. Ett arbete som har krävt otålighet och uthållighet i skön förening. Den här dagen är en seger för friheten. Sverige har gjort ett fritt, demokratiskt och självständigt val att gå in i NATO. Det finns ett överväldigande stöd för det i vår riksdag och hos det svenska folket. Det är en styrka för Sverige och för alliansen. Ett svenskt NATO-medlemskap är inte slutet på någonting. Det är början på någonting nytt. Jag ser fram emot att tillsammans med alla allierade och tillsammans med USA göra världen säkrare och friare. Thank you all so much.
Please remain in your seats as the delegate.